This is Jody Rudorin of the New York Times reporting from Gaza City, where we saw the deadliest day of this escalated conflict with a massive strike this afternoon on a house in Gaza City, killing 12 people. Most of them belonged to a single family, the father survived, and many, many people from the neighborhood watched for more than an hour as they struggled to pull bodies, many of them children, out of the rubble. The death toll here is now over 60. There are also three Israelis killed on Thursday in the town of Kiryat Malachi. Rockets continue to fly from Gaza into Israel with direct hits today in Ashdod, where 10 rockets flew and all but one were intercepted by the Iron Dome missile defense system. Also direct hits in Ashkelon and the southern town of Sderot. There were missiles again headed towards Tel Aviv, but they too were intercepted. After several days and weeks of increased rocket fire from Gaza into Israel, Israel responded forcefully on Wednesday by killing Ahmed al-Jabri. He was the operational commander of the Al-Qassam Brigades, which is Hamas's militant wing, and that's what really set this in motion, the last several days of extreme violence, punishing airstrikes by Israel, endless launches of rockets by Hamas and other militant factions here. All this violence makes the possibilities of a ceasefire seem very remote to the people here. But there are talks going on in Cairo, in Washington, and in Jerusalem towards a possible deal. Egypt is trying to broker such a deal between Hamas and Israel with the help of Turkey and Qatar. The Palestinian leadership in the West Bank is also trying to get involved. They plan to call tonight on the Arab League to use its leverage to try to broker a deal. And one of their representatives, Nabil Shaath, is scheduled to land tonight here in Gaza to visit with people and work with Hamas. 4 years ago, Israel's ground operation split the Gaza Strip in two, killed hundreds and hundreds of people over 2 weeks, and terrorized the population. Nobody wants a repeat of that, not Israel, which lost a lot of legitimacy in the international community, and certainly not the Palestinians, but it's unclear if there's any way to reach a deal to avoid it.